There are only three certainties in life: death, taxes, and that the Golden Triangle mining stocks are going to spike at the end of summer. Hi, this is Fabi with Equity Guru, and today I want to talk about a company that, to be completely honest with you, when I heard the name pop up this year here and there on Twitter, I thought, nah, I missed it. I know for a fact that this stock has already spiked. I missed my chance. Whatever they have going on, I'm not interested because I'm probably going to pay too much of a high price in order to profit from it. Well, it turns out that this particular stock has shown to be quite predictable. And whether you're a long-term stock investor, whether you're more of a trader short-term, you should most definitely take a look at this because I believe that this year is going to be a lot better than last year. Last year, not everything went right with this project. And I think that they have those things figured out for this year. I am definitely taking a second and third look into this.
So this is Aben Resources. I'm going to scroll right down to the part that really matters, and I'm going to come back a bit. So most companies, regardless of where they are, cannot boast of a team like Aben Resources have. You got to give it up to them. They have one of the best geos in the region. His name is Ron Nedelitsky, and I know it's a mouthful, but this guy, as you can see here, this man, he has found three projects that have become mines, two of them in the Golden Triangle. So if you ask any investor that has been doing this for long enough, that has made many, many millions, they're probably going to tell you, look, I invest in first and foremost people of high caliber. And when you ask them to define what high caliber is, they will probably tell you, well, people that have past successes, and this is the important part, within the area that they're trying to succeed again. So this may mean a type of deposit that they're looking for, or it might mean a geographical or geological or political jurisdictional area that they are trying to basically replicate the success that they've already had. So this is huge for an exploration company to have such a good guy on board. If you add up both companies that have been founded from Ron Nedelitsky's discoveries, then they come up to almost $1 billion. Now here you have another clue. Jim Pettit has also made a high-grade gold discovery and sold it to New Gold in 2014. But you can say, yes, okay, but that was in Ontario. Yeah, that's fine, but you maintain the theme of high grade. Tim Termwende, president and CEO of Copper Canyon, also a huge success story. Again, the theme comes up, high grade copper discovery, also in the Golden Triangle. That was sold to Nova Gold. Now here you can see what the companies did during this time, and you have multiple baggers here. Not too shabby. So now let's take a look at their structure. To be honest with you, 132 million shares is a bit on the high side, I believe. Their market cap is just around $19 million, but their treasury is, I believe, 5.5 million. And this is quite good. That means that they have enough to drill this year without having to go to the market and dilute further. Notable shareholders, you'll see here, management and insiders, very important to me. Eric Sprott. Now, Eric Sprott is almost like a kid in the candy store when it comes to these discoveries. It's almost like he doesn't want to miss any of them. I'm not saying that this is going to definitely be a huge discovery, but it's very seldom that Eric Sprott gets involved in something that doesn't really go anywhere. Now, they have these three projects right now. The Justin Gold project is very early stage. It's in the Yukon. So I'm not going to focus on that very much. There's a Chico Gold project in Saskatchewan. There seems to be a bit of a social license problem, which has been a reoccurring theme in the last few years, as you can see. So we're not going to focus too much on this. We will focus, however, on the Golden Triangle project that they have of Forrest Kerr. Now, before I go into the technicals of the project, you're probably more interested in this. Now, when you take a look at this chart, there aren't many things that are as predictable as this. You can see here 2016, 2017, and 2018. What do you see? Well, you see three huge run-ups, and they all happen in late summer to early fall. You have here the high of 2016 in mid-August, then in 2017 this happened mid-September, and then again late August you see it again. From top to bottom, you're talking, I believe, a minimum of a threefold run-up, sometimes up to almost five times if you get out at the right price. Now, the reason for this is the area where they are. It's the Golden Triangle. So the Golden Triangle is an area in British Columbia known for very high grades. It's quite a remote area, and when they drill it, they always seem to come up with intercepts that are very, very attractive, especially if you're looking at other companies and they're hitting 1 to 2 grams of gold per ton. You know, from the Golden Triangle, you can expect anything from, I don't know, maybe 7 grams per ton gold to something like 30 or 60 grams, which is obnoxious. Now, because these are explorational companies, by the time that the results come out, it's usually late summer, and that's why you see a spike, but then nothing happens during the winter. Their season is probably about 4 months long, and so you have people selling the stock and then buying it again and then selling after the results are in. The area that they control is actually massive. Now, the Golden Triangle in the last few years has seen almost half of all BC exploration budget. And you can see here, there's a few known names such as Pretium's Brucejack. Pretium is a $2 billion company. They are producing. Red Chris has just been sold for $800 million, I believe. So you have all sorts of projects being worked on in the Golden Triangle. Now, some of the reasons for this is that there used to be a lot of glaciers in the area that are actually receding. And this is huge because there is ground that just simply wasn't available to be drilled, say 20, 30 years ago, that is now ready for the drill. One criticism of the Golden Triangle area is that it's very remote and you could never really build anything of value there because it's far away from everything. That has actually improved with the larger projects that have actually become mines. There has been a lot of investment made by the government, which makes this more and more feasible. Now, in order to control this area 100%, Aben must spend $3 million until June of 2020. That's only the summer of next year, which means they will drill this baby out. You know that this money is gonna go into the ground because it's been turning up really great results. Now, when you look at this map here, I want you to pay attention to this red line. Okay, this red line cutting across here. And this is a Forrest Kerr project. You have here some highlights. North boundary zone is the area with the best results to date. And the south boundary zone, there has also been gold found here, but just the intercepts weren't as good as the north boundary zone. We're gonna get into them a little bit later. Now, recently the BC Geological Survey people have come up with a statistical model that says that within about 2 kilometers of that red line, you are more and more likely to find most of the major deposits in the region. So basically, their location is perfect for what they're looking for, statistically speaking, from the studies that have been made so far. Okay, so let's take a look at the boundary north zone. So these are some of the holes that have been found so far. 331 grams per ton over 1 meter. Now, I don't want you to go thinking that 331 grams per ton is anything like what you're going to find pretty much anywhere else in the world. 1 meter is not very long. You need to find zones that are much larger than this, but the richness of 331 grams is just off the charts. I mean, if you can find more meters that are about a tenth of this grade, then you're doing very, very well. That is within a zone that has 10 meters of 38.7 grams, which is what I just said. That's still extremely high grade. From a decent depth, 114 to 124 meters, that's not very deep at all. And that includes 6 meters of 62 grams per ton. Super high grade. So when something this high grade is published, then you have this effect. Then you have that spike that's expected when the results actually come out. Beautiful, visible gold. It's not always needed, but I gotta say, it doesn't look bad. Now for the south boundary zone, they haven't found as high grade, but they have found higher showings of copper and something that could be considered high grade almost anywhere in the world. They've also found gold along a longer zone. So 1.2 grams over 122 meters with a bit of silver and a bit of copper. It's not really the headline grabber that you usually have for golden triangle plays, but it's something that in other areas of the world, this could really skyrocket a lot of other stocks. Now, I want to draw your attention to the fact that in 2018, and you'll see how the stock performed here. Let me bring up a 1 year chart. You'll see that they had very sharp drops with gap downs and things of this nature. Well, they had one very large problem, and that is all their drilling was done in 9 pads, as opposed to the 40 that they needed to do the project. So basically they need permits in order to drill. Those permits, instead of getting to them within 90 days, took 200 days, which means they lost that season. The bad news was that was for last year. So you see the stock dropping a lot. You also have the fact that for this year, all the permits are in place. So instead of only drilling 9 pads, they're going to be able to move around and actually drill all the directions, all the places that they need to. They have enough money to do so, and they're ready to start drilling. So if I had to take a guess, with the money that they have in the till, with the project the way it is, the grades that they have already found and the information that they've been compiling, the people that are working on this, if I had to make a bet, I would say that the spike this year might actually be higher. If not higher, it may be sustained for longer. I don't know. I just don't see how this could get flat to low for the rest of the year. It does not make sense. These guys are going to put some results out, and the chances of there being millions of dollars put into the ground for absolutely no results in an area that we know for a fact is very rich in high-grade gold is almost nil. They've recently put out news about the Justin Gold project, but because it's so early, I believe that they're going to use this as a way of sustaining the stock when there is no news about the Golden Triangle, the Forrest Kerr project. Definitely worth a second and third look. I am now researching a little bit about the Golden Triangle in and of itself, and believe it or not, I know people who are now seemingly just making bets in the Golden Triangle and doing a rinse and repeat kind of strategy. I don't know if this is your thing, but it seems like it's too predictable a pattern to ignore. So tread carefully, but definitely watch out, because I believe this is going to be a really exciting summer for Aben Resources.